Greening, good to have you with us on the 9 p.m. edition of the Urban Debate. Viewers, tonight we talk about the big controversy revolving social media giant Facebook. And we ask the question if political parties are extensively using and abusing social media giants as political tools to manipulate and influence the voters. A conversation we've had multiple times in the past, especially when the Cambridge Analytica controversy cropped up. But this time, it's a lot more serious. How did it all begin? Let me tell you, if you've not gone into the details yet. The story actually became into a massive controversy when the Wall Street Journal printed this story. Now, what does the WSJ report really say? It says that the Facebook's public policy executive in India was opposed to applying hate speech rules to specific groups and parties, including the BJP. The larger allegation is that there is a bias within the social media giant, and while they crack down on certain hate speeches, they don't always do it with the same zest, keeping their business interests in mind. This report goes on to quote unnamed officials within the Facebook to say they thought the officials sought punishing violations from BJP may damage their own business and business interests. The report says they claimed there was a pattern of favoritism towards BJP and Hindu hardliners. It also then gives on specific examples. It says how Facebook did not take action when there were numerous articles being floated around by allegedly BJP-backed pages and BJP-supporting pages accusing Muslims of being the ones who spread COVID in India. It also cites several other examples of alleged inaction against BJP backers. It reports that the Facebook didn't even disclose that it had removed pages with fake news tied to the BJP. While there were numerous disclosures made about action against other political party-linked pages, the ones linked to the BJP were never revealed. Now, viewers, as this began to turn into a big political fight, with Rahul Gandhi and the Congress Party picking it up, and now seeking a parliamentary probe on this entire setup, seeking answers from the Facebook. We also saw another development. The top executive of Facebook here in India, Ankit Das, has actually filed a complaint alleging death threats over this story. That after this story came out, Ankit Das began to get death threats online and has now filed a police complaint, which has been converted into a case. Makes you wonder that if social media giants are unable to protect their own people from this kind of online hate and death threats, then what kind of systems do they have in place to protect you or me? Or is it simply a lost cause now, with us having to turn towards the law enforcement agencies? Now, the complaint by the Facebook executive says death threats on Twitter and Facebook. Accused makes sexually colored remarks, circulating photo with defamatory comments, subjected to name calling, cyberbullying, subjected to Eve teasing. Horrific that this happens. Horrific that this kind of a reaction happens every single day to so many people on social media, and we don't know what to do about it. We are unable to stop it. How do we address this controversy? What's the accountability of social media giants? What do we know about the alleged bias or neutrality of Twitter or Facebook? How is it that repeatedly these controversies emerge of political parties using them to influence the voters, and we are not able to bring this to a stop? Some of the questions that I have in mind. But let's say good evening to the panelists who are joining us right now. Gopal Agarwal, National Spokesperson for the BJP. Nikhil Pawar, Editor for Media Nama. Dr. Ajay Kumar, Spokesperson for the Aam Aadmi Party. Abhishek Datta, National Spokesperson for the Congress Party. And Shivam Shankar Singh, Data Analyst and the author of a book, How to Win an Indian Election, that goes extensively into how political parties really use social media as well. Let me actually begin with Nikhil Pawar to get an understanding of just how deep-rooted this problem is, Nikhil. Irrespective of the party, we've got multiple political parties on this panel tonight because we believe they're all using social media in one way or the other, as is being alleged. But help our viewers understand how deep is this entire system.
No, look, social media, Tanvi, is very, very important for society. It is the carrier of free speech. It is the platform that enables us to express themselves. Ourselves, you know, some expressions may be good, some may be bad, some may be inciting violence, like the BJP politician mentioned in the story, allegedly did so. There was inciting violence and shootings. I just want to make one thing very clear. Ankit Das's job is to recommend what is best for Facebook, not necessarily what is best for India or what is best for the citizens of the country. And it is a reflection of the political environment that we are in, that her recommendation in the interest of her company was do not shut down the account or this post from a BJP politician. Now, few years ago, maybe let's say 8 years ago, it could have been the same reaction regarding a Congress politician. And so we need to realize that the political environment in our country is such that companies are afraid to take action against hate speech by politicians. That's the reality. It may be worse with BJP. It may have been worse with Congress. I'm not getting into the political debate of who's better, who's worse. But our laws definitely are such that they are being used, they can be used to victimize companies. And so companies will try to protect themselves. She's just doing her job. And now what her recommendation was, I don't agree with it. I think, and in the Supreme Court's verdict in 2015 on free speech under Shreya Singhal was very clear that incitement to violence should be prosecuted. My question is, even if Facebook did not act, and Facebook is not accountable to the citizens of this country, but the law enforcement agencies are, why didn't law enforcement agencies act on this matter? Why didn't they? Because this is clear incitement to violence. Why wasn't the politician arrested for inciting violence right there? Right. So we can't depend on platforms to act for us, because they will always do what is best for them and not necessarily what is best for citizens. But we also have to be very conscious that if the outcome of this controversy is that we have more regulations over social media and government takes over more control over how social media platforms operate, that will basically mean more power in the hands of the government and therefore more power in the hands of the ruling party. This is a no-win situation for users, a no-win situation for democracy. The only solution that I see is that there needs to be transparency and accountability within Facebook. Even now, we don't know who took the decision to keep that post up or to keep that account active. Ankit Das recommended that it remain up. So I think how does Facebook take these decisions? We don't know.
How do they take those decisions? We don't know. We're repeatedly told, even by Twitter, when we've had these debates over alleged bias by them or against one side or the other, they say, well, there is barely any manual intervention. There is no bias. But perhaps more transparency on that front is needed. Nikhil, before I go across to our other panelists, you say that we can't blame them since they acted out of their own business interests. But are there enough examples to suggest that if they had taken action against whichever political parties, backers or leaders are putting out such speeches, their business interests would be hurt? Or is it just a thought in our heads?
No, but I think it's a legitimate fear because tell me a business in this country that feels comfortable taking on the state. How many times do just look at budgets. How many times do our industrialists criticize a budget? Businesses are scared of politicians. They're scared of the government. I don't need to prove it. We've seen it all across these years.
Okay, let me bring in Abhishek Datta. Abhishek Datta, first it was the Congress party allegedly in cahoots with the Cambridge Analytica for elections. Now it's the BJP that's getting a free run apparently by the Facebook. What's happening? Are political parties using this at a widespread scale to influence us and getting the help from social media giants?
See, I just want to read out the statement that came in the paper, which was very clear. Facebook hate speech rules collide with Indian politics. We must realize what this article has said. This article had very clearly said that within Facebook, there were two thoughts which had come forward. There was a set of people who thought that things the way are happening in India are not absolutely right and they should be checked. But at the same time, the Facebook Indian team tried to help them and even at the same time try to encourage them. What was the whole agenda? If you go behind, it is not only now that the Congress party is talking about it. Even in 2018, Praveen Chakravarti was the head of the Congress IT cell at that time. He specially went to the US to meet the Facebook agency and tell them about this whole spread of hatred on Facebook, where biased decisions are being taken. Certain things that the Congress party is advertising has been controlled, and there is one hate group which is being promoted, and the same thing has been reflected in the papers now. And even after having three meetings with Facebook in 2018, then 2019, very recently in this year, Rohan Gupta, who heads the social media team of the Congress party, specifically wrote to Facebook telling them about these issues which have been raised in the paper. And what is dangerous that has coming out is, it is not about politics, it is not about elections, it is about the entire country, the way this hate thing is spreading. Look at the followers on Facebook. We have nearly the highest followers in the world, followed by WhatsApp. We have 40 crore followers on WhatsApp. Anything which is hate, anything which is not right for the country is being spread, and there is no control over it. What the Congress party wants is a JPC. A JPC must investigate why Ankit Das was promoting certain groups which were spreading hatred on Facebook, which Facebook itself is talking about. It's not the Congress party who talked about that. The Facebook internal team talked about it, but her answer was very clear. The moment you control these people, a very big business loss will happen in the country where the government is concerned. And at the same time, they had applied for a WhatsApp license. That license had not been cleared. So this was very specific, the reason why they were quiet about it.
Okay, but the fact of the matter also is that in April 2019 itself, Facebook cracked down on Congress Party IT cell and removed over 687 pages that were linked to the Congress Party that were spreading fake news by the IT cell of the Congress. So clearly they gave you the long rope as well.
No, I'm glad you've got this out, Tanvi. What is alarming in this issue is when pages were being deleted, even for Bharatiya Janata Party, the pages were being deleted. But when the statement came out from Facebook, they never mentioned about Bharatiya Janata Party. Why were they only talking about the Congress pages being deleted, which is absolutely fine, we're not against it. But why didn't they mention about the Bharatiya Janata Party being pages not being deleted? Can the spokesperson of Bharatiya Janata Party answer that? This is favoritism. This is exactly what the Congress party is raising. Why is there favoritism? Why is policy, which is in Brazil, the policies are very different. In America,
no, Mr. Abhishek Datta, I will ask the BJP spokesperson when he is here with us. He's still getting connected. But I am finding this very amusing that your problem is that Facebook is biased in punishing bad behavior, not the fact that all parties are resorting to bad behavior.
Not at all. If you read the article properly, I don't think you're reading that article properly. The article very clearly says...
I am reading the article very well, but I also tend to have a better memory than most people, and so my memory goes beyond this article as well, Mr. Datta.
Do you read two names that they mentioned about in the article? Do you talk about Ankit Das? Do you talk about Shivnath Thakur? Do you talk about the association of Ankit Das with Rashmi Das, who happened to be an ABBP activist in JNU? Why certain people who are creating these hate speeches are automatically connected to these big companies? Do you talk about that right now? Do you talk about the fact that such hatred is being spread on Facebook? And who are these people who are spreading this hatred on Facebook? And the sad part is, most of these people who are spreading hatred are being followed by the Prime Minister of our country. Do you talk about those things which are mentioned in the article? See, at the moment, let's make it very clear. We are not talking about Congress, BJP. We are talking about the ethics of our country. How can you allow hatred? How can you allow, you know, religion hatred speeches on Facebook without being checked? Our idea is very simple, that call for a JPC, investigate the matter, why certain preferences are being given to Bharatiya Janata Party. Who are these people who are involved with ABBP? Who are these people involved with Bharatiya Janata Party, who automatically happen to be the control stakeholders in Facebook? Why Ankit Das is having different policies towards the incumbent government and against those in the opposition?
Okay.
You talk.
Right. Right. Let me bring in Dr. Ajay Kumar as well. Dr. Ajay Kumar, do you think a parliamentary probe is what will get the truth to us? How do we get to more transparency?
Look, Tanvi, the couple of issues. One is, like my colleague Mr. Pawar correctly said, that it's a matter of, you know, the money power also playing. So if you want to go into a larger issue of why this is happening is, there is no control limit by the Election Commission on the money spent by a political party. You have a candidate limit on each candidate. There's a limit, and Indians suddenly feel very happy that we have a very honest election and money power is not there, which is the biggest myth and biggest nonsense, you know, in this whole discussion. So when there's no limit, party like the BJP or whoever, whenever they are in power, whichever, whether it's the Congress or BJP, whichever party is in power, has much more access to money. They spend a lot of money. And Facebook works on advertisement. I don't know if you remember, Tanvi, Elizabeth Warren put up an advertisement of Trump endorsing Elizabeth Warren on Facebook. So the issue again is, Facebook has remarkably failed in India especially. Now, Ankita's involvement, how much she was promoting her company is a different issue. But the fact is that where Ankita's and Facebook failed was the barometer of removing hate irrespective of whatever its origin, whether it is the Popular Front of India, whether it is the BJP-minded or the IT cell, or whether it's the Congress promoting fake news. If Ankita's or the Facebook in India as a company had put the barometer of saying, look, any kind of hate which promotes hate will be highlighted. This is the process. It will be transparent. Take an example like what happened in Bangalore riot. Suppose somebody is setting up a Facebook post of hate. You know which is the methodology. Now, we don't know how to complain. What happens to your complaint? What is the methodology of closing? And Facebook, despite being one of the world's largest corporations, just miserably fails because it works in their favor to have this kind of a setup. Now, how do we fix it? Definitely, I think all the state governments, like what the Aam Aadmi Party has done, I think Mr. Raghav Chadha has given a notice to Facebook in India, ask them to explain their, because we have a committee which looks at promoting hatred and enmity. So Mr. Chadha, as the chairman of that, gave a notice. And we need everybody in this country to start with the TV channels allowed inside these proceedings, have a discussion where the people can see what does Facebook do, how is hate promoted, and Tanvi, all of us who are on this panel are very much aware of what messages we get on WhatsApp. I mean, the kind of nonsense we have, even
how is hate promoted, Dr. Ajay Kumar. My larger problem is that if you're going to be biased in what you allow and what you don't allow, then you're allowing certain political parties to promote what they want. Fake news, hate speech, bias, agenda, false narratives to mislead the voters. Any of it and all of it can actually be done. And this is not the first controversy that Facebook is finding itself in. Everybody knows the whole controversy around US elections and how, the allegations against Facebook and their involvement in this. Everybody knows the controversy around Brexit and the allegations against Facebook and their alleged involvement in, again, pushing through a specific narrative. Now, I don't care if it's BJP's narrative or the Aam Aadmi Party's narrative or the Congress Party's narrative. But who is going to hold them accountable for this? Yes.
No, Tanvi, I'll give you an example of how things go crazy. There is very clear evidence of where the present Home Minister gave a statement in Rajasthan in September 20th saying the incumbent Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh has slapped his father. It was false. But he said, we have an ability to send this message all across India, all across Uttar Pradesh. So that definitely influences election. Now, how do you control this? The only way to control is set up a transparent guideline, get them to meet in a JPC or similar format, and then create an authority which is independent of political parties. Because political parties, whoever comes in power, whichever government is in power, will misuse it for their advantage. Now, we have to evolve as a democracy. And believe me, our democracy, as we move towards more social media and WhatsApp, we are definitely endangering the pillars on which we stand. Hate is being promoted. The people who are inimical to India, people who are inimical to democracy, everybody's going to use it. So it's not only political hatred and political advantages being there. If you continue to spread hatred towards each different political parties, don't you think you can spread hatred between different communities? between different castes, and then it leaves India more endangered. So it's not controlling Facebook and hate is not, okay. It's in our natural interest. Because today we are, because it's on a political issue. But if you use it, then people who are against India can start using it to develop fissures within our social, within the country, and start creating hate between castes and between communities.
Okay, all because right. I have to go to two more panelists. Dr. Ajay Kumar, I get your point. Nikhil, 30 seconds to you, because then I need to go across to Gopal Agarwal of BJP and Mr. Shivam Shankar Singh as well. But yeah, Nikhil, you had a point?
Yeah, Tanvi, I mean, I'm a little surprised. What is censorship for one side is going to be suppression of free speech for the other. Are we really going to let a private entity be held accountable for what it decides to suppress and what it decides to allow at a time where we are not even able to hold Delhi police accountable for not acting on videos of hate speech from two politicians during the elections, where they very clearly incited violence. We are trying to accord a greater accountability to a private party than we are to our government officials and our government entities. And you know, the more control we give to the government over these entities, the more we are going to see that they will lean towards one side versus the other. I don't think we can expect neutrality from them. But what we should expect is, where Facebook has failed us by not censoring this content, why has our system failed us where that politician wasn't held accountable by the courts or by the police for statements that they made? We seem to believe more in Facebook's ability to deal with these situations than, you know, expectations from our government to deal with it. I don't think we can trust Facebook very clearly and to be able to do a perfect job in terms of
censoring content. Okay, I get the point that you're making about your concerns, Nikhil.
No, I'm just saying that we need to investigate.
Yes, I get the point that you have a concern about the government getting a control on a private entity. I am at no point sitting here and saying that, irrespective of what other panelists may say.
Yeah.
Yes, but the fact that you and I may understand the intricacies of this.
Yeah.
You and I may understand, Nikhil. Let me just finish this point. You and I may understand the intricacies of this. Not everybody who is using Facebook or WhatsApp or Twitter is going to. And thereby, we are staring at a larger situation of building and pushing false narrative by whoever has Facebook on its side. That is a problem for me. Now, I am not saying the solution for that is for the government to have more control. Absolutely not. Because if that be the case, like you pointed out and you cited several examples, in real life examples outside the social media, we would have seen a lot more justice being done. Fair enough. I take that point. But there has to be some solution. Let me bring in Gopal Agarwal and then Shivam Shankar Singh. Mr. Gopal Agarwal, all this while, you and your party kept saying that these social media giants are biased. They're blocking the right-wingers, they're blocking the views of right-wingers, deleting their accounts, deleting their handles, not letting them speak. It now seems, as per this report, that actually these social media giants were helping you and your party.
Tanvi, the issue is that we all again stand by the same that what we had been saying, that this Facebook and other social media and other certain social medias and other media houses, etc., have a anti-BJP bias, and they are controlled by left and ideological, certain ideologies which control them. But your accusation is, and some people are accusing, just because a Wall Street Journal, which has posted this article, which is referring to certain employee, which they are not even identifying, that he said that the Facebook head from India said this in the meeting, that we need to have a BJP bias to control our business, help our business. And therefore, this is the effect of the situation. It is not like that. We know that Wall Street Journal has an anti-BJP bias. They have been publishing this kind of reports, and they have been many times found out to be incorrect. So it is one media against another media. Facebook has
clarified. So you believed it, Mr. Gopal Agarwal? Mr. Gopal Agarwal, you believed it when Twitter was biased against the right wing, helping the left wingers. Now you believe this is all false because this doesn't suit you?
What I'm telling you is the law of the land will decide what is hate and what is biasness and what thing. It cannot be left to just a social media platform. What is Nikhil?
The law of the land is not deciding, sir. The law of the land is crawling and dragging its feet, only picking up a certain side of the cases and hate speeches. I can give you a dozen examples right now. What action has been taken? What action has been taken against the hate speeches that were made in the run-up to Delhi election and after the Delhi elections, Mr. Gopal Agarwal?
Tanviji, you want to
That's a different case altogether. I am asking you right now about what the social media giants are doing.
We are not believing social media. You want to say that the social media have more credibility than the government machinery. That is what you want to prove here. Is this
you mean the Delhi police? No, I don't want to prove. Don't try putting words in my mouth, Mr. Gopal Agarwal. I am simply saying, on ground, you are not giving us justice in the hate speeches that are being done. Why are you telling me to believe in law of the land? What has Delhi police done in all the hate speeches that were made in the run-up to Delhi election? Tell me, please.
You are asking me to believe what Wall Street Journal sitting in US is doing, is talking about all the things is correct. You want to believe all India like this? Ultimately, if you have any problem or anybody has any problem...
No, I'm simply asking you, will you not investigate now? Your party was the first to jump and summon Twitter for a parliamentary panel meeting. Won't you summon Facebook now? Why don't you call Mr. Mark Zuckerberg now instead of calling Congress losers?
No, the thing is that Congress is jumping on the occasion. They are saying that they are writing the judgment before any investigation. Rahul Gandhi is saying that
Let me remind you, Mr. Gopal Agarwal, that when the Cambridge Analytica controversy happened, your government and minister said, we are going to summon Mark Zuckerberg and seek accountability. We are going to call Twitter officials and seek accountability and transparency. Right now, you are simply saying that news reports are false. That's what is happening. Shivam Shankar Singh, thank you for patiently waiting. My apologies for coming to you so late.
Absolutely no problem, Tavi.
Yes.
I think there are two separate issues which have been meshed together.
Give us an insight.
Yeah.
Yes.
So there are two separate issues which have been meshed together. One issue is hate speech not being punished by the legal system and the police system of this country. That issue is something that the government should be taken to task for. They actually have not punished hate speech in a lot of cases, Delhi riots being one of them. There is a completely separate issue of social media giants regulating what is allowed on their platform and what is not allowed on their platform and who makes these decisions. My primary problem with this is that right now we do not know how Facebook and Twitter make these decisions. Once you report something, exactly. Who does it go to? Why is someone who is responsible for liaising with the government also controlling content on the platform? That in itself is a huge basically conflict of interest that we haven't been able to move past. And Indian media has known about this for a while now. People have talked about it. There have been articles that have come out about Ankit Das. Wall Street Journal is not the first thing that has pointed it out. We just have not talked about it in the public space. I am glad that we are talking about it. And what needs to happen is that these social media giants need to come up with a clear policy about what is going to be censored, what is going to be allowed, how they're going to enforce these policies and who are the people responsible for enforcing these. And the people who enforce it should be separate from people who make commercial decisions and from people who make decisions to liaise with the government for other business interests.
Will that help? Will that help Nikhil Pawa in separating the two? Because, I mean, if at the end of the day, the CEO of the company is going to say, no, business takes precedence, how does it matter what other policies you make?
Look, I think that separation already exists at a global level because there's a separate content board that they have, that Facebook has. And we don't know who's actually taken the decision. Ankit Das may have made a recommendation, but we don't know whether she's actually acted on it or someone else higher up in the hierarchy at a global level has acted on it, right?
Once they have actually
done something. I agree with you, Shivam. I'm not disagreeing with you. Shivam, I'm not disagreeing with you. My primary concern here is that, you know, the impact this has on safe harbor for platforms, because this is a perfect opportunity for the government to weaken safe harbor, for the government to weaken the neutrality of the platforms and take more control. And that is going to be even worse for us. So we as users are in a situation where whatever happens, the outcome is going to be bad for us from the looks of it. And I'm very worried about that aspect. The internet runs, our free speech is possible online because of safe harbor protection. And the Indian government right now is going through a process of amending those rules. Will this particular situation allow them to make the rules even worse? I don't know, but I'm very worried that that might be the potential outcome of it. And we will live to regret any change that happens because of this particular one incident that has come to light that there's this entire debate about. I'm looking at a broader long-term situation for our speech online.
So I would agree with that. But
okay, but I might say, Nikhil, in that sense, for the administration to respond to this and actually bring in any changes, Shivam, just 1 minute. I'm coming to you only, but I just wanted to say for the administration to respond and bring about any changes to make the social media giants more accountable will also probably mean them accepting that this was going on. So maybe not this example, but maybe the next incident that happens, your fears might come true. Shivam Shankar Singh wanted to make a point before I go back to the political representatives.
Yes. So the issue here is that when we talk about regulation for the social media giants, it's not just regulation by the government. That is something that will actually give more power to the government. But the social media giants themselves have a responsibility to regulate the content that comes on their platform out of their own free will. What we see right now is that they are failing to do that. So what we need are global regulations that basically specify what kind of content should be removed, how these policies would be enforced, and then leaving it up to the social media giants to enforce these policies.
But that's exactly what happened, Shivam, that there is clearly incitement to violence is meant to be taken down, and the platform did not act on those norms. The Supreme Court of India's ruling under Shreya Singhal mandates that free speech should be restricted when it's incitement to violence. And they didn't do anything. So we can't depend on the platforms also to always execute what they're supposed to do.
Validation of the point that you're raising right now. Because if the platforms could and would, then the platform's own top executive wouldn't have to go to the police. But they have, and they're asking the police to take action. So perhaps we will have to start looking at tougher legal and policing responses to when these incidents take place. Here is the top Facebook executive saying, I am getting threats online, my picture is being used, false narrative is being set, and you know these posts are being spread around.
But
she herself doesn't know what to do.
Mr.
Gopal Agarwal.
Two separate things. Filing a case is very different from being able to take it down. It can be taken down and yet a case be filed, especially when there's threats coming at them. I think they're two very distinct things. You can't expect Facebook to put someone in jail, but you can expect a Facebook executive to file a case against someone who's threatening her.
Tanvi ji.
Okay, point taken. Mr. Gopal Agarwal, do you want to come into what our experts are saying?
I just want to tell you that the problem is there in the social media. Government also agrees, and now many of the debates, everybody, panelists and even opposition, they are also agreeing that there has to be a certain regulation. Now, who will regulate, and can we leave this regulation to a social media platform that they will decide what is hate speech, what is freedom of speech, and how to manage them? This cannot be their own prerogative. We have several complaints from our people which are right to center that Facebook has been, I have also faced certain times that my post they don't show. So how they can decide on what is the correctness of what is the issue? Can you leave this all regulation and implementation and decisions, etc., to a social platform is only my concern. I consider that we have to have faith in our institutions which have been built over 70 years since independence. You just cannot say that a certain person or political party or ideology has a problem with our ideology, our way of thinking, our way of expression. That means that it is wrong. How you are giving that right to particular Rahul Gandhi or to Sitaram Yechuri? They have been themselves have been party to these kind of activities. Congress was party to Cambridge Analytica. So how can Rahul Gandhi decide that Facebook is supporting BJP or RSS? So you now only limit yourself to this, that there has to be an investigation, regulation. And there I agree that social media has to be regulated. And there has to be a body over
there. No, but Mr. Gopal Agarwal, you haven't responded to the point that was raised.
The police.
Now, I don't think they're saying there should be government regulation at all. They are actually saying make Facebook accountable and make them more transparent and don't bring in the government to regulate a private entity. But you haven't answered the question that was raised here. That shouldn't the government's job actually be to act against those who are using hate speech? Rather than asking Facebook to take it down, why don't you act against them?
Yes, so
why haven't you acted against them?
Because all the examples that have been read out in this article and so many other articles are about hate speeches by our own party members.
So you talk about that, we'll talk on that. You are talking now on Facebook, why should I talk on other things? Then I'll talk on many cases.
Because it's
there.
Relevant.
Yes, issues like hate speech on Facebook.
Yeah, this app
people. Hate post on Facebook.
What they were doing. Then what on
so
the
tell me, Mr. Gopal Agarwal, if there is a hate post on Facebook or Twitter, if there is a communal rant on Twitter or Facebook or any WhatsApp, who is going to take the legal action? Is it not the government?
It is the government, but it has to be a through process. You just cannot say ki, if the X is saying that there is a hate speech or there is incitement of violence, you have a right to complain. But you cannot say the whole process has to be subverted just because certain sections of the society feel that this is a hate speech. There can be certain facts also which have been stated. So there is an FIR, there is a police investigation. If you say that we are completely biased, we are not transparent, we don't have a right to governance, that is your own wish. We are not agreeing to that. So that can be there. Some people, the Congress may always say, or AAP will always say, but the way they are operating, what they did in Shinebagh, the way their MLAs have been acting, what they are doing in that. So why Dr. Ajay is talking about like that? So you tell first arrest them, then throw him out
of
the debate.
Okay, Dr. Ajay Kumar.
Then,
Dr.
Ajay Kumar.
So Tanvi, a couple of things. Firstly, Shaheen Bagh. By the way, the way BJP has made the main collaborator.
Now BJP
in
has made it.
I don't interfere, sir. तो आपको भी तो बोलने दीजिए. तो first question is, I would ask Agarwal ji that he's a decent person, but I would want him to know that has BJP in any of the thing, the government of India filed a single FIR on hate speech, which is from their party people. Raja Singh, all their party people, whether it's Parvesh Verma, whether it
you
is the Minister
about
Singh, Goli
Maro. We will talk about
sir, let me complete, sir.
I ask you a question,
so,
sir.
Arre, yaar, Gopal ji, mujhe bolne to dijiye pehle.
Bolne
na,
sir.
Please, to listen to what I say. I will complete and then, sir, you can respond. My question is very simple. The hate speeches will continue. Like Mr. Pawar correctly said, the legal system files an FIR. But you can file an FIR against a doctor or an engineer who posts something against the government. In UP, it has become a disease and epidemic. But hate speeches in this country, by and large, goes unpunished if it is of political value. Now, who will take the action? The present
in Delhi,
government
you
is
will
supposed
take
to be... The most part, no, you will file an FIR, sir. You are not filing an FIR because it benefits you.
Why you will not talk?
Tanvi, my only question, Gopal sir, just let me finish. My only question is, if the BJP says it claims victim Gopalji on hate speech today, then I am absolutely stumped because you and I know the kind of hate which is spread against community, against party, against different people, and all sides are guilty. But the reality is you have more money, you are able to support the democratic process more. Aap ek kanun laiye ki you will file an FIR IT to an independent online FIR for hate speech and we'll support you. We want you to come up with some law like that, that anyone in India can file an FIR for
okay,
hate speech.
Okay, before...
And you see that?
Let me before Gopal Agarwal responds to that, Dr. Ajay Kumar, let me take your point and ask the Congress Party also this. Congress Party, Abhishek Datta, and then Mr. Gopal Agarwal, you can respond to both. I'm sure you'll want to respond to Congress as well. Abhishek Datta, do you agree to this point? Let's make it more about legal action against those who make hate speech on or offline or online, wherever it is, rather than going after the social media giants. The government should focus more on those making the hate speeches.
Tanvi, I just need 2 minutes because they have been sharing their thoughts. First of all, you must realize what is the demand of the Congress Party. When we talk about JPC, we have 3 specific issues that covers everything that they've been talking about. I don't want to talk about individual events like Shaheen Bagh or something else. This is a very bigger issue that we need to discuss over here. Our first demand is, why are these people in Facebook and WhatsApp who are working with their organizations have got connection with the Bharatiya Janata Party? Our second point is, when Ankit Das is talking about the commercial deal that will be influenced in case a decision is taken against those people who are promoting these hate speeches, what is this commercial deal? And our third issue, which covers all the point, is very basic. How Facebook is influencing the elections and the hate speech campaigns among the Indians. These are the basic demands in the JPC that the Congress Party wants. I want to tell my friend from the Bharatiya Janata Party, Congress is not raising this issue for the first time. Whether it was in November 2018, when NewsClick had reported 5 series naming these same officials who are encouraging hatred on Facebook, whether it is about the Congress delegation flying to Facebook office in America, or whether it is about us emailing their head talking about these instances where certain things are not being promoted and certain section of the Indian political system are getting a bigger benefit, which is furthering damaging the democracy of our country. I don't want to talk about one event that they're discussing. Why can't our country formulate a policy to control this hatred? When this lady from Facebook reports to the police about the hatred or about the threat mail she's getting, imagine what the country is going through. She's one individual who's gone to the police reporting this FIR. There is so much of hatred on Facebook. On WhatsApp, there's so much of unverified messages which are spoiling the entire country. So it is a bigger issue that the government needs to address. It is not about Bharatiya Janata Party winning or losing election or Congress winning or losing election. It is about our country. There has to be a policy because Facebook is an influencer. When there are 20 crore people on Facebook and WhatsApp watching videos which are not verified, which are spams, which are spreading hatred, it is a major concern for our country. It is not limited only to elections. So this is what we need to address at the moment. And the incumbent government must come up with a bigger plan how to control this. If they are not coming out with a plan, maybe they are trying to encourage this. My last point, look at the power of Facebook. Ravi Shankar Prasad and Anurag Thakur had summoned officials of Twitter, of Facebook and WhatsApp. And you'll be surprised to know, none of them appeared in front of the government and they sent very junior officers. Who are these people who are giving them so much of power that even when the ministers are calling them for certain issues, they're not reporting? That means there's someone very big in this country who's trying to protect them and who's helping them to influence their agenda in this country.
That's not factually correct. I'm sorry.
Okay. Gopal Agarwal can now respond to both, and then we will go to the experts.
Can you please tell me what is not factually correct?
The CEO of WhatsApp has met Ravi Shankar Prasad on fake news on WhatsApp. He's met him twice.
If you look at the statement made by Anurag Thakur, you know exactly what I'm talking about. By the time the BJP spokesperson speaks,
I agree with you on those instances. But if you're, it's not correct to say that none of them have ever met Ravi Shankar Prasad, etc., because they have met in the context of fake news on WhatsApp. I'm just correcting the fact. That's all. I'm just sharing the correct fact.
Okay. And I also think at the beyond a certain point, that's immaterial because all these companies still exist, still thrive in our country. So yes, Mr. Gopal Agarwal, I'm coming to you only. Don't worry. Go ahead.
The one thing is, Mr. Ajay, Dr. Ajay Kumar is very extremely fully free to file an FIR. He doesn't need to wait for the government, central government, to file an FIR. Every individual can online file an FIR if he has certain problem. Why he is saying that only the government should file the FIR? So if he has certain issues, he can file the FIR. These are all false narration, putting the responsibility on everything on the government, and then saying, talking big issues. That's not the fair thing. Is that second thing is the Congress has always been talking about the fake news. The issue is, we all agree that there has to be a regulation and regulating of the social media platform. I agree with the Congress spokesperson here also. We needed them always to be regulated. Just to connect this incidence to BJP is that we are talking about. You are just waiting for a report, which is from a so-called report, a statement by an employee of the Facebook, which says that the their India head talked about that they are not taking action against BJP because their business interest is hurt, will be hurt, and this report, his statement, not even name is there, and being quoted by Wall Street Journal, and we are jumping to the conclusion that it is the BJP that is being controlling the Facebook, etc. We have several occasions where our own people have been victim to Facebook discriminatory policies, and it's not one time. There may be places where they have faltered on the BJP support, but there are many cases where they faltered against the BJP also. So the thing is that they are not the right person to regulate this thing. There are many issues. Read the article of Rajyavardhan Rathore today, and even the Karnataka MP Tejaswi Surya is saying that there are so many complaints. If you want, we can tomorrow come out with the whole thing and give you. That's not the issue. But we all know that there are several occasions where Facebook have faltered, where BJP has been the victim of their discrimination. So this thing happens. We all agree. We need to regulate. The thing is, who will regulate and who will make the law? It is the I am of a firm opinion.
I think the thing is, Mr. Gopal Agarwal, we need to know who is going to ask for government. More transparency, more accountability, more transparency, not regulation. Regulation is not what the government will do, because the issue at heart in this specific example is the bias and the favors to the government and the ruling party. So your solution is not really going to really help allay our concerns and fears about any kind of bias to whoever it may be. BJP today, Congress tomorrow, the Aam Aadmi Party the day after, depending on the election, depending on the money, depending on the business interest. That's not how this is going to work then. The answer has to be transparency in this specific case. And yes, I agree with what our experts are raising here. If there is fake news, if there are false narratives, if there is hate speech, and communal hatred and divisive nature in the post, it is also important that the legal agencies, the police and the governments, take action and not just leave it to the social media giants to regulate all of this. Far too many times this entire controversy has come to the fore, viewers. What remains to be seen is if any action will be taken. One cannot simply dismiss this story by saying, oh, it was filed by an international media organization that may be biased against our party. There are many within our own country who've raised these issues, including their own articles, not being boosted on social media because they were allegedly against a certain party. This kind of bias and discrimination, whether it gets fixed or not, you as a viewer need to make yourself aware. And so before we figure out what Facebook does or Twitter does or the BJP does or the Congress party does, you as a viewer need to know the power of these social media tools. And while you use it and make them a bigger and a bigger part of your daily lives, understand that they're also being used to push, sell certain narratives, to target you, to influence you. Keep that in mind when you use any of these social media tools, including the WhatsApp. Thank you so much for joining us on this conversation. A big thank you to all of our panelists.